Today's the 19th, y'all. I got court in about Monday. You feel me? Monday, I have court for my niece. We going back to the library because I got some more things I need to back off. So y'all gonna see some more of this journey right now. Sometimes, as I say, even though, you know, we may think that we have all of the answers and everything to everything right away, sometimes we still have to be out here in these streets still making some more moves. As far as, you know, right now I'm going back in here as far as, and I'm about to be ready to print off some things again. I'm about to fax off some more information. I'm actually about to send off some subpoenas as well. I'm about to see if they even have a notary in here. So these are things that I'm gonna have people that are gonna be on the journeys. Like I said, this first case is for my niece. So I will be most definitely letting you guys know about each journey, each and every journey that we're taking. Right now, as I said, I'm gonna be back in here about to do some faxing. About to be ready to see if they have a notary in here. Because when you notarize something, that does make it a legal document. So I just really wanna, you know, really show this process, guys. I'm opening up my personal journey, and I'm gonna be hoping that it's gonna be some other people that wanna start speaking up for our melanated babies. Somebody gotta do it, like for real, because families definitely aren't doing it. If your families aren't doing it, then let God hope that we have a beautiful melanated black community that actually want to speak out as well for these babies like I do. Big ups to my melanated community that is speaking out. I totally appreciate it. And, you know, there's helping out, speaking out, supporting. And thank you so much. I'm glad to be showing you this journey. Done. That took me probably about an hour to, and I'm still not finished because I still have to go and fax off. I decided not to fax because from there, because I do have to go get some things notarized to make everything that I did do legal. And like I said, I was subpoenaing some people, like making subpoenas go out to people that have been ignoring this situation as well. So, in this journey, you must not be afraid. You must do this wholeheartedly. You must stand up as a part of the melanated community, not to be afraid, because sometimes we make it, you know, we might be afraid to make moves. You know, especially when you have to go up against people that know what's going on and you got to subpoena them to court and everything. I also would like to say, going on this journey, I like to make sure that anyone that does decide to have a journey with melanated awareness, that you make sure that you follow all of the directions, okay? Make sure you read in your direction following. Make sure you do your own research, but we're gonna definitely be there to push you in the correct directions. Sometimes we try to shortcut things, and I can say that for myself as well, but when you shortcut, then you end up having to still go back and do it. If you really dedicate, you're still gonna end up doing it. But to make things easier, it's better to go ahead and do it right then, and, you know, just take care of your business right then. Sometimes we might get tired or whatever, which I think that's been the case with me lately. I've been tired, you know, I've been drained from this, but I gotta still keep on moving. Sorry about the beeping here. Out here today too. I'm still moving though, you know, in my journey. because I'm putting this awareness out there that this can be done. We just have to get out there, do paperwork. Like I said, my niece has her own folder that I have put together for her. And it's getting thicker and thicker by the day because I have to continue to print off work and, you know, make, I have to do a lot, okay? So her folder is getting thicker. But right now I'm about to get ready to go and fax off some information, get some things notarized, and I'll be sharing part of that journey as well. So I'm here at UPS now, y'all. I'm not really gonna take this on the inside because of the simple fact that it's other people in here and I don't wanna be doing a bunch of filming. I'm trying to get in, get out. I'm about to do fax this. And they actually got a notary at UPS, y'all. All right, so I just got done with that. That literally, like I had to make a whole bunch of copies. I had to fax a lot. That was a total of $18.50 to get some things notarized. I got a bunch of paperwork faxed off. I had to fax the people that need to be subpoenaed, which it was three different people that had to be subpoenaed to court. I'm subpoenaing defects, you feel me? Because I'm really going in, you feel me? It's not a game. We cannot continue to play with these babies. So I'm subpoenaing all the people that have literally, I'm getting to court to subpoena the people that have literally been ignoring what we have been, the information that we've been putting out there for my niece. So I totally gotta continue to thank my melanated community, the ones, sorry again about the beeping, the ones that are reaching out and helping me. I'm showing what I'm doing. I'm showing my journey. I will continue to show my journey. Right now, I just got something notarized, which actually, let's see if I still got my envelopes in here. Because you gotta keep your envelopes on you, you feel me? Things like that have to be kept on you because you never know when you might have to just go, you might have to just fax some things off. And I don't see my envelopes. Oh my gosh. I got a whole big thing of envelopes, so, and they're probably at the crib. Meaning, I'm gonna have to go to the crib and get them. So, as I said, this is, it's time, gas, sacrifice, money. These are just the things that have to be done. As we start doing these cases, I'm sure there's gonna be a lot more things that's gonna be done in a more orderly form. We're not lawyers, but we're gonna do the things, we're doing the things that lawyers do, understand? So at this point, I have just got through faxing all the information over to the court systems. I have something that I have to mail out to the court, so I'm gonna go and pick up my envelopes, because like I said, I got a whole box of envelopes that I use totally just for this situation right here. So I'm gonna go find my envelopes, but I'm just showing y'all what you gotta do. You gotta be out here on these streets doing this footwork. All this yapping and talking around in the families, you know, being very secretive about what's going on with these babies. Nobody's helping out with the situation. None of that's gonna help get these kids out of the situations they are in. We have to use the systems that are out here. Reason being, we don't have our own system. So if you don't have your own system, you gotta fight with the system that we have. Understand, it will work, but you just gotta use it and you just gotta keep on. Even if you gotta like do the appeals and everything, which because I have so much evidence, I don't think that that's gonna even happen. But we'll see, because you know, like I said, this system is broken. That's why we need our own system, people. We need our own system. But I'm gonna continue to make my moves. Like I said, I'm gonna be leaving town. So right now, I'm gonna be leaving town Sunday. So right now, all I'm doing is just preparing the last bit of paperwork, the last bit of, you know, the evidence and everything that I have. And I didn't even think about, you know, we just thought about just going ahead and subpoenaing them today. So if I had really been thinking it when I got back from Georgia, I should have did it right away. But then the court date would have been sooner than what it is now. So I guess I needed it to be done right now. So, yeah. I told them when I first started calling up to the defects and everything to find out about what was going on with my niece, and they had an open case, and they, you know, basically blew it off like it was no big deal, even though this woman said that my niece's parents were deceased and they didn't even check into it. And, you know, I asked them, why wouldn't they check into something like that? But I told them, I was like, y'all gonna know my niece's name in this office, you feel me? I mean that with everything that I have in me. They gonna know nature's name, for real. So, as I said, I will continue to show you guys the journey. Probably gonna be a lot of videos for me over the next few days and so forth, especially when I get into town and, you know, everything, you're gonna be seeing it. I think I did say earlier I did purchase the tickets for the airplane. So, shout out to everyone who helped with that situation. I totally appreciate it. And I'm gonna go ahead and get off right now, and I will be hitting you guys back because I got one more thing that I need to send out. A couple more documents I need to send off. Notarized legal documentation that needs to be sent off. Certified. You feel?